Hello friends and welcome to this video. My name is Nivruti Patil. In this video we are going to see the MATLAB solver for curve fitting and interpolation problems. So let's see first for the curve fitting. We may need to fit the curve for the different types of equation like straight line, quadratic, power and exponential, and we need to find the constant terms, that is a and b values, and in case of quadratic equation a, b and c values. So in MATLAB the solver syntax is polyfit in bracket x comma y comma n, where x and y are the given data points and n is the power of equation. So let's see for the first type of equation, that is a straight line equation. The straight line equation is of the form y is equal to x plus b, and for this given data points we have to use this polyfit syntax. So let's see in the MATLAB. In MATLAB we know y, so x will be defined by using again square bracket. So x value was 0, 5, 10, 15. After each value you need to give the space. Then define the y values as in square bracket. Y values are 1.8, 1.45, 1.18 and 1. Give the semicolon to suppress the answer and write this solver syntax, which is polyfit in bracket x comma y, and then give the comma and write as a 1 for the power of equation. Hit the enter key, we will get this 2 answer. First answer is a constant term A and second answer is a constant term B. So using this polyfit syntax you can get the small letter A value and small letter B value. Now let's see the next type of equation as a quadratic equation. The quadratic equation is of the form ax square plus bx plus c, and here the power of equation is 2. So the solver syntax is polyfit x comma y comma n, and at the place of n we have to write as a power, that is a 2. We are going to use this x and y values in MATLAB to get the three constant terms a, b and c. In MATLAB I have already defined the x terms and y terms and directly writing the solver syntax, that is a polyfit in bracket x comma y comma the power of equation is 2, and again hit the enter key, so we will get the three constant terms. So first is the constant term a, second is the b and third one is the c. So in this way you will be get this three constant term for the quadratic equation. Now let's see the next type of equation is the power equation. First considering the power equation of the form y is equal to a b raised to x, and then we need to convert this equation into a straight line equation. So we are going to apply the log on the both sides. Now in this case we are applying the natural log on the both sides. So we will be get the equation is in the form. And after comparing with the equation, straight line equation y is equal to x plus b, we can write it as capital Y is equal to capital B plus capital A into x, where this capital Y is ln of y, this capital B is the singular term, so it will be a ln of a, and capital A is the coefficient of x, so a will be get as a ln of b. The x is as it is small x, but y is the log of y, and to get the small alphabet a and b we have to apply the anti-log, so we will be get as a is equal to e raised to b and b will be e raised to a. So the solver syntax is polyfit x comma log of y comma n, because here x is as it is and y is nothing but the log of y. Again n is the power of equation, which is 1. So let's write in the MATLAB. MATLAB we already defined the values of x and y, so directly write this solver syntax, which is polyfit in bracket x will be as it is and y will be written in terms of the natural log. So natural log will be written as log in bracket y, then give comma, write as 1 as the power of equation, and then hit the enter key. So when you hit the enter key you will be get these two answers. The first answer is a capital A and second answer is a capital B, and as we have to find the small a and small b, so small a is equal to, small a is nothing but e raised to capital B, and b small b is nothing but e raised to capital A. So we need to take the exponential of the terms. As a is equal to e raised to capital B, so we have to write as a exp in bracket capital B is nothing but this second term. So second term is assigned to variable ANS. So we have to write as exp in bracket ANS in bracket 2. And when you hit the enter key, you will be get the answer for small alphabet A. Similar fashion, B is exp of A, and A is nothing but this first term. So first term is again assigned to ANS variable. So we have to write ANS in bracket 1 and hit the enter key. So you will be get the values of small alphabet B. Now let's see the next type of power equation. The next type of power equation is of the form Ax raised to B. Again, we need to convert it into a straight line equation by applying the natural log on both sides. Again, comparing the equation with straight line equation will be written as y is equal to capital B plus capital A into x. So where capital Y is ln of y, capital A is small b, capital B is ln A, and capital X is ln of x. So again, to calculate the small letter a and small letter b, we need to take the antilog. So we will be create as a is equal to e raised to b and small b is equal to capital A. And the polyfit syntax will be written as polyfit log x comma log y comma n, because here the x is log of x and y is a log of y. So x will be replaced by log x and y will be replaced by log y. N is again 1 for the power of equation. So let's see in MATLAB. Here again x and y values are already defined. So we have to write polyfit syntax in bracket. The x term will be replaced by log of x. So natural log will be written as log in bracket x comma y will be replaced by log of y. So it will be written as log in bracket y comma, then give the 1 for the power of equation, hit the enter key. So again you will be get this first answer as a capital A, second answer as a capital B. Again, as we need to find the small a and small b, so small a is nothing but e raised to b and small b is capital A. The next form of equation is exponential equation, which is of the form y is equal to a raised to bx. So again, converting into a straight line form, we have to apply the natural log on both sides. So we'll be get, and again simplifying, we'll be get as a ln y is equal to ln a plus b into x, as ln of e is the 1. So again, comparing it with the straight line equation, we can write as a capital Y is equal to ln y, capital A is equal to small b, capital B is equal to ln A. And by taking the antilog, we can get the small a as a e raised to b and b is equal to capital A. So same form, the polyfit syntax will be written as x comma log y, because here again x is the, as it is small letter, and y is the nothing but the ln of y. So it will be written as log y comma n. So let's see in the MATLAB. Now in MATLAB, again the x values and y values are defined. So we have directly write the polyfit syntax in bracket x is as it is comma log of y comma 1. That is the power of equation. Again, hitting enter key, will be get first answer as a capital A and second answer as a capital B. As we need to find out the small alphabets A and B, so small a is equal to e raised to b. So e raised to b will be written as exp in bracket. The b value is this second value, which is assigned to variable ans. So it will be written as exp in bracket ans, again in bracket 2. So we will get the small alphabet A, and b is nothing but the capital A. So b will be written as this first value as a ans 1. So ans in bracket 1. Will be get the answer as 0.20. So in this way you can find the constant terms A, B and C using the polyfit syntax. Now let's move to the next topic, interpolation. In interpolation, we have given the x values and y values, and we have to find the value of y at a given value of x, where x is in between x1 to xn. So let's consider these x and y values, and the solver syntax will be written as inter p1 in bracket x comma y comma xg comma spline, where x and y are the given data points, xg is the value of x at which we have to find the value of y, and spline is the method of interpolation. So let's write in the MATLAB. In MATLAB we have already defined the x and y values, so let's write the syntax, which is interp1. This is the syntax for getting the interpolation values. Then in bracket we have to write the x comma y, which is given data points, then comma the value of x at which we have to find the value of y. So considering the value of x as a xg as a 1.5, then give comma and in inverted quote write as a spline, which is the method of interpolation. When you hit the enter key, you will get the answer of y, that is the value of yg. So in this way you can find the value of y at a given value of x using this interp syntax. And if we want to find the value of x at a given value of y, then the process is called inverse interpolation. So we can simply interchange the x and y values to get the solution at a given value of y. So thanks for watching.